Hey everybody, Connor McIver here, and I want to give you a heads up as far as values go. We look around the internet for different services, you probably do too. The questions always come up, how do I know I'm not paying too much for a house, or if I want to sell a house or find out where my value is, how do I do that? And you'll find some of the larger search engine sites, just from your property address alone, you'll see that they're giving you a value. So they're telling you, well, your house by this particular address, it has some kind of a software algorithm, or somehow it does determine what it believes your price is. What we've noticed, however, is a lot of those systems, they don't differentiate between a property that's right on the beach or 3 miles inland from the beach while it's within the same city. The other thing that those systems don't put together when they're allowing you to look for values on your property, they don't talk about granite or upgrades or expansions or any kind of changes to that particular property. It's looking at it as if it's just plain Jane, or it's just matching everything else out there. So how do you get it right? Well, a lot of you out there that are watching the video are totally concerned with contacting any one of these systems to have it generate for you a property valuation for any particular piece of property. And you know what, I totally get that, because then you have to change your number, you have to change your name, you have to go into hiding because you have all these agents chasing you down. So this is what I recommend. Wherever you live, whatever city you're interested in living in, find a local agent, because with a local agent comes a lot of accountability. You contact the local agent, you have them produce for you a valuation on a particular house, condo, townhome. Then if they continue to harass you after you've decided maybe not to use their services, or you've decided to use somebody else, then you can call them up and say, hey, Agent A, leave me alone, pull me off all of your email spam list, and just step away from the car. No, but anyway, that gives you an idea on how you can handle that. Whenever you sign up on these larger websites to get some kind of property value for your home, be careful, because I get leads from a lot of these major sites that they're sending me, and they're also not just sending that to me, they're sending it to 15 other agents that are also paying a particular fee. So at the conclusion of this video, I will show you how the market snapshot system works. It is free, it's without obligation. Yes, it's a local resource, so if I ever tap you with any kind of spam or junk, which we don't, but let's say somehow it occurred, you call me and you say, Connor, cut it out, and I cut it out. That's it. Enjoy. I hope you enjoy the video, the screen video of this particular system. It does work well. We have been using it probably better than 3 years now. Our clients have, and it works really, really well. All right, let's go ahead and check it out. Hey everybody, Connor McIver. Let's talk about property values. This is the second part of our video series here, talking about how you get the better property values and where you can look for those systems out there. Now, we did cover that when you're going online, looking at the big systems are fine, or is fine. However, some of the issues as a result of that, you're going to get bombarded with information from people that you actually don't want to talk to. So, okay, that's that. So here's what you do. You come to paris911.com. You see here, see our Mac box. The system that, one of the better systems out there that we use, and again, we're a local source, so any information that you give up doesn't come back and bite you. We respect your privacy and everything else. So just get that. When you come here, any one of the cities in Santa Clarita Valley, if you're outside of Santa Clarita Valley, you can utilize the word California market snapshot. But just to give you an idea, I'm going to punch in Castaic market snapshot, and I'm going to hit the button. So boom. So now it's going to give me information, or a widget that's going to show me all of the value within Castaic as far as listings, comparisons between your property and another, or in fact a property that you might be wanting to buy in another. They're going to give you an idea as far as what properties are selling for in a 5 mile radius or less, where the unsold home's at, and also it gives you a lot of information as far as typical questions that people have with regard. So we're going to go ahead and load this up here, And just to give you an idea to see what the market snapshot's going to entail, and if you look here, there is a lot of information. It's going to give you different properties are going to render on here, the target property, either one that you're looking to buy or your own is going to be rendered on this particular map, and you will be able to pick out the rest of these. Property number three is right here. This is going to be 9611 116th Avenue Northeast. So you can get an idea of what's going on right around your particular home, and it is quite detailed. You can see that the red is going to indicate sold, the green, of course, listed, and the target property is going to render with an upside or an actual arrow pointing down to the ground. You can move over here and you can check out an enlarged map here. So we can go ahead and double click on it, and this is going to give you a whole screen view of what's going on as far as property prices, average asking, high, low, and recent sales. And very, very detailed. Let's go ahead and jump back to this other system here. After asking and sold prices, then you can also expand asking versus the sales price, and we can pop this open here, and you can also view this in its entirety. The system continues. It does talk about time on market, and you know, in real estate, that's a very important facet. And you'll be able to see properties, how long they've been on the market, the sweet spot, or the average within the system. The generation you can look for, this goes from April 30th to July 31st, which is today. So the data is updated quite frequently. And finally, the number of homes, it'll give you nearby homes, new listed, and also total sold. It's also going to correspond to date. So it's a lot of good information. Not only does it talk about the real estate information, but it does go into detail as far as community, shopping and services, public services, places of worship, recreation, leisure, and it will give you all of the information. Also, a big question is schools. What's going on with schools? Here is that information that you seek. You can see the different schools here, and you'll be able to pull this up whenever you get this particular data from our sites. So that's it. That's just Castaic. So the trick is by going to paris911.com. If you don't remember anything else, forget the cities, punch in market snapshot into the Mac box, and you'll get the system. So it'll pull up all that data. You'll get it. You'll be able to view it, look at it, and we look forward to helping you soon. Thanks so much for watching the video, and you know, I have a lot of fun. Talk to you later. Bye.